class. This is Brandy, and welcome back to Astro Tarot Research. I asked and you answered, astronauts. Here are the results of the poll. Am I on the right career path? That is the reading that we will be doing today. If you are not familiar with that poll, you have to go on over to that community tab. I will be polling you astronauts from now on every Tuesday to see what readings that you will be interested in. Now let us jump into these piles. We have 5 piles to choose from as always, but wait, before we get started, you know what I'm going to ask you? I'm going to ask you to please like, to please comment, and please subscribe. I would love for you to join us here and become astronauts and just learn all about astrology and the other world. Now, let us get into these piles. We have pile number 1, pile number 2, pile number 3, pile number 4, and pile number 5. So let's not waste any more time and just sit back, relax, and choose. Hey, pile number 1, let's get started on your reading and if you are on the right career path. We have the Magician. We have the 5 of Pentacles. We have the Moon. We have the 10 of Wands. We have Prayer. We have Be Careful What You Wish For. And Saturn Return. Okay, this is very interesting. A lot of complex messages for you, pal number 1. And you may even feel drawn to either 2 other piles because I see some repeating cards here. If you wonder how I see repeating cards, I film these out of order. So I never know which order I'm going to film in. So that's how I see the other piles. But pile number 1, first of all, my first thought when it comes to are you on the right career path is looking at all of this. Yeah, I guess my thoughts are yes and no, okay? And I say yes because we have the Magician, and the Magician is there to let you know that you can achieve whatever it is that you put your mind to and set out to achieve. For example, I got the Magician just last week, and I was nervous about running a meeting because I was running it in front of a lot of important people, right? And it was my first time doing it. And I was like, oh, how will I do? And I got the Magician card. So the Magician is somebody who is well-versed in communication, who can be successful if they put their mind to it. And ultimately, I got a lot of compliments on how I ran the meeting, right? So yes, if you put your mind to it, whatever you set out to do, whatever you plan to do, it can be achieved. But then my second thought is, we go to this card, Be Careful What You Wish For. And when I'm looking at this card, Be Careful What You Wish For, and then I'm also looking at the Moon here, along with the 5 of Pentacles and the 10 of Wands, there's a lot of hidden elements that you may not be completely assessing, or you may not be accounting for when it comes to achieving your goals. Okay? So, for example, this could possibly be like you're working hard to achieve your goals, but ultimately you are a part of a team environment, right? You work hard, you get a promotion in your career, you're part of this team environment, but then you realize quickly that this team isn't very supportive of each other. In fact, a lot of the times, a lot of the load gets put on you to achieve things, to get things done. And people just aren't pulling their weight. And so it's like you are pushing for these areas of success, but you're not thinking about all the possible circumstances that could possibly be in. Or you may not, I'm not saying thinking about it, because sometimes it's kind of like you don't know what you don't know, right? Which is this Moon card here. Another example could possibly be like suddenly, you know, get this dream job, right? You get this wonderful dream job. You are showing up every day. You're doing your work. You have a lot of opportunities to show off your skill set, But then you're in this environment where people are a little shifty. There's a lot of office politics going on. People are spreading rumors. People smile in your face and then, you know, they stab you behind your back. People are like overly competitive or overly ambitious. They look out for themselves. And so I think what the cards are saying is that you're potentially on the right career path, but don't be alarmed when there are circumstances that come up that are not exactly idealistic or what you wish for or what you want to happen. The moon card here, and I've done a study on like moon ruled nakshatras and moon ruled men. I don't know if I put this in the study, but a lot of the times when we have moon ruled placements, it connects to deeper hidden agendas. So not only are you thinking about your own goals and what you want to accomplish, you have a million and one people also thinking about their own hidden agendas and what they want to accomplish. And when I get the moon card here, quite often, and you'll see this in a lot of moon rule people's lives, is potentially they will be manipulated to achieve somebody else's purpose. And they get into a place where they are eventually disillusioned or deprogrammed away from that sort of mentality that they were eventually put under. Okay, if that makes sense. It's kind of like, I think I said in the Moon World study, it's kind of like how, you know, men and women are socialized to be a certain way. Like, women are supposed to be like friendly and focused on like their appearance, and men are supposed to be looked at as these leadership qualities and not be emotional and, you know, never let people see you sweat and things along the lines of that. And then as time passes by, if you have any sort of, I guess, intelligence, you start to question those narratives and you realize that you've been manipulated into thinking that way. And there's no women are this way and men are this way. It's just we're all people, right? And we all have emotions and we all have thoughts and we all have different ways that we express ourselves. And there's no one way women act. There's no one way men act. And so when it comes to your career and going on the path that is truly right for you, there's going to be some moments of disillusionment. There's going to be some moments where reality is going to hit hard. For example, in America, I don't know, people watch from ever. I think most of you are from the US, but, you know, a good portion of my subscribers are not. So in America, I think since 2022, there have been these major layoffs from tech companies. So on social media, we saw all of these images of people getting like these car services to go to work. They're getting dropped off at the office by these buses. They're getting these Michelin star meals. They're getting work paying for their gym memberships that cost like $200 a month. They're getting all of these perks and, you know, month-long vacations and exotic company trips and things along the lines of that. And then all of a sudden, these tech firms start laying people off. And they start dropping them like flies, right? It's like, I think since 2022, it might have been like almost 500,000. I might be exaggerating. It might be just like 300,000 people have been laid off from tech companies or something like that. And these are people who are highly skilled and highly qualified. Like, you have to be at the top of your game to work at Google. You have to be at the top of your game to get a job at Tesla. So there was a moment for disillusionment for those people where they've worked hard. They have studied their butts off. They've made sure they stand out in their resumes, and then they were dropped like flies. And so what the cards are saying is, yes, you're on the right career path, but don't be shocked if there's some moments where you're going to have to deal with office politics, where you're going to have to deal with gossip, where you may even deal with job loss if you haven't already, where you're going to be overwhelmed and overburdened. And I think that is what this Be Careful What You Wish For card is trying to emphasize. It's saying things are not all, you know, sunshine and roses. And I'm sure you know this, But I think what it's saying is there's more to the picture than you even realize, especially when we have this Saturn return. Saturn is the planet of standing on business. Saturn is the ultimate wake-up call. There's a reason why everybody is fearing their Saturn return. There's a reason why people fear Sati Sati, which is like when Saturn transits your moon sign. Because Saturn is that planet that applies pressure, that puts the weight of situations on you. It's that saying, pressure makes diamonds. And Saturn actually rules diamonds and gems and things along the lines of that. But it can be so stressful and so overwhelming. And there's just going to be so many moments that are just like, oh my God, I want to pull my hair out. So I think ultimately, pile number one, I do want to say yes, because I don't want to sit here and harp on about how things are going to be a struggle and how things are going to be, people are going to be a little bit more, you know, hidden with their agendas and et cetera and X, Y, Z. I do want to say that you have the opportunity to fulfill all the things that you desire and all the things that you put your mind to, but it's going to require so much from you. It's going to take a lot from you. I'm not going to lie. The moon card here, especially when I get to connected to the Ten of Wands, can sort of represent having high levels of stress and maybe even possibly dealing with some mental health issues, meaning things like anxiety, things like depression. Especially when I did my moon rule study, a lot of moon rule people suffered from depression. Like they openly suffer from it. They said they had high anxiety, high depression. A lot of mental problems come with the moon rule placement. And so the thing is, there's just so much pressure, especially like I did a video on Saravana. And Saravana is like the combination of the moon and Saturn. Wow, I just realized we have the moon and Saturn in this placement. And Saravana has to deal with this type of energy, this Ten of Wands energy, where they have to carry not only their own mental burdens, but the burdens of people around them. Like they kind of have to remain strong for everybody around them. So for example, I believe the leader of Ukraine, I can't remember his name right now, he's even spoken about how he wants to remain strong for his people, and he has a Saravana placement, right? He's obviously going through his own struggles and his own issues, but can he get on TV and start crying about his own personal problems when he's got a country that's at war? Absolutely not. And that's the pressure that Saravana's on. Another placement that has Saravana placement is Britney Spears. And think about all the craziness in the 2000s. Remember how she was very Five of Pentacles, right? She didn't have any support. Especially in the 2000s, people were vicious. The attacks were vicious. She had so much pressure on her. She's over here shaving her head. Her mental health is down the toilet. She's being attacked on L levels. She's having gossip spread about her. She's having lies spread about her. She's having people manipulate her, lie to her to get fame out of her. She's got weirdos like her ex, Kevin Federline, using her to, you know, pivot his stardom or do whatever he's trying to do to put himself in the limelight. Just a lot of heaviness comes with this. So, but think about how successful Britney Spears is, right? She's one of the most famous pop stars of all time. So the cards are saying, yeah, you can achieve success, but there's going to be a price to pay, okay, in the direction you're currently going. But this does not mean that things can't pivot and that you can't reassess and you can't challenge your current beliefs. And that's what I want to get into next before I completely turn you off, pile number one. If you're still here, I do want to give you that little pot of gold at the end of the rainbow moment. Because when we're talking about this be careful what you wish for energy, sometimes this can possibly be having to do with reassessing personally if your values currently align with what it is that you are looking for in your career. Do your values match up to what it is that you're trying to achieve? Are you chasing the external validation of wealth, meaning, not wealth, of success, meaning having a lot of money, being a part of these high-class social circles, having a lot of fame, having a lot of beauty, having a lot of notoriety, having a huge friend circle, you know, with things like that, having a huge, massive home. Are you chasing expectations that are set across by society? Like I said, with this moon rule thing, are you being influenced by circumstances and things that don't truly connect to your soul and who you are? Or are these things that you truly want and desire for yourself? Does it align with your long-term values? Does it align with your long-term happiness? I hope I'm not getting too preachy, because I know personally I hate when other people get too preachy and I'm just like, I don't want to do that. But I do want to share these messages because I think it gives an overarching picture to things, is what I'm saying here. Because at the end of the day, all that glitters is not gold. I think you see it all the time when people talk about how celebrities or Instagrammers, like, they fake their dating lives, they fake the popularity, they buy subscribers, they buy listeners, they have those song farms to stream playlists. When you go to these celebrity events, it's just a room full of people who are kind of a little bit awkward. Like, it's just this, like I mentioned, it's like this all that glitters is not gold energy. And potentially the path and the success that you will achieve in the long run, because like I said, you can achieve this. You very well can achieve it. It may not necessarily be something that connects to your authentic self. Okay? That is what I want to say about that. But I do want to look at this prayer card, because we haven't really dived in deep with this prayer card. So let's see what this has to say. Prayer. In times of need, in times of hurt, in times of anger, it's easy to turn outward and focus on what we do not have or what we want the most. But remember, gentle soul, you are always allowed to ask for help, to ask for guidance, to ask how, to ask why. Don't forget that you are never alone. The divine is always with you. To seek it, my love, all you need to do is turn inward. And that's prayer, guys. And so, to me, that messaging and how it connects to this card is that follow your heart, follow your true intuition. It will guide you to the right path in which you want to go on. And that, like I said, everything you want, you can achieve. Like this said, all you have to do is ask. Ask and you shall receive. Don't forget that you do have this divine guidance with you. Don't forget that you do have strong intellect, strong intuition, that you are someone who is highly reflective, and it's more important to focus on things that are inward. It's more important to focus on things that money can't buy. It's more important to focus on your spirit and your soul, because I think what the cards are saying, focusing on external validation or external things isn't ultimately what's going to bring you that true growth and that true sense of fulfillment. It's just going to feel like pressure. It's just going to feel like stress. It's just going to feel overwhelming. It's just going to feel like you don't have a moment to even think for yourself. And it's going to be hard. I think ultimately I want to say like that these goals that you're trying to achieve and that you very well can achieve, because you are such a capable, smart, talented person who works hard and who has gone through some struggles, especially with this Five of Pentacles here. You've been in this place of lack. Hell, you might even still be here now. You may be in that place where people have defined your worth and said you weren't good enough for certain things, where you haven't been able to afford all the things you want, where you've had to work your butt off, and you might be currently working your butt off now. But these things that you might be working your butt off for, it may not feel like this is what you needed, okay? I think the takeaway from this reading is to focus on all of the ways that this could play out, to focus on the good and the bad, to have a more realistic perspective when it comes to achieving your goals. Think about literally the details, because this is ruled by Mercury, and Mercury is all about the details. Think about day to day, what's that going to be like for you to live and achieve your goals? It kind of reminds me of like how you have a lot of, I'll say this, women who may want a guy who's very successful, but they don't think about the fact that usually highly successful men, they're going to be working on vacation. They're going to work long hours. They're more than likely not going to be able to answer your calls or spend a lot of quality time with you. They're going to miss birthdays. They're going to miss holidays. They're going to miss anniversaries. More than likely, they may not have the highest level of emotional intelligence because they're so focused on the work and the grind and achieving what they want. They are focused a lot on appearances and external validations. That's why they're chasing the wealth. And so they're going to have expectations about how you should look, how you should dress, how you should act, how you should present yourself, because now you're a reflection of them. A lot of them can be very like manipulative and controlling. Like they may pay for things and give you things, but those things come with terms and conditions, things along the lines of that. They don't think about how there are other men or women who are, they're going to have to sort of deal with, who may be coming after or trying to seduce the person that they're with because that person is so visible. And that person is going to have a lot of admirers, and they're going to have a lot of people flirting with them, and they're going to have a lot of people trying to get with them. They may not think about what that means for starting a family or thinking about prenups or thinking about the legalities of coming together and things along the lines of that. It gets heavy. And in the same way, you see a lot of guys, and I'm just being heteronormative right now. You can literally apply this to any situation or whatever sexuality you have. But you see a lot of guys who particularly may want a woman who looks a certain way, but they don't think about what it takes to look that way. They don't think about how long it takes to get dressed, how long it takes to put on your makeup, how this woman will care about her appearance. So you're probably going to have to take photos of her and take videos of her. And more than likely, she's going to be on her phone a lot because she wants to, build some sort of empire based off of, you know, the visuals or fashion or looks or makeup or something along the lines of that. How that person may attract a lot of attention. They may attract a lot of men. And then, like I've mentioned before, a lot of studies show that people, the more attractive that they are, the more likely they are to leave their partner because they perceive it in a way to have more options. And they perceive their life in a way to have more options, which is kind of true because people are shallow. So they do have more options. I mean, think of like a Jada Will situation, right? Or just Hollywood in general, how a lot of the couples aren't long lasting, right? Because everyone's exercising their options, right? So think about everything through. I'm not saying that specific situation is true to you at all. I'm just giving examples. So I'm just trying to throw things out there. Think about what comes with the day-to-day of the career that you want. What comes with the lifestyle? What comes with the obligations? Think about taxes. Think about how much effort you have to put in. Think about every element of things. Think about it all, okay? And really write it down, and honestly, really look at the people who are having that lifestyle. But most importantly, check in with yourself. Connect with yourself emotionally and see if that is the right fit for you. Think about how your work will impact your life. Okay, but the answer is yes, you are on the right career path. It's just, I think some adjustments need to be made in order to emotionally protect yourself from any future hardships. So that is what I have for you. I mean, you know, maybe if this resonates, you know, please let me know if it resonates below. Please let me know what you're going through in your career. I am so curious to hear about this, pal. Number one, you have a very interesting reading going on here. Like, this is definitely a very complicated situation. And, If this doesn't resonate with you, feel free to choose another pal, or maybe I'm not the reader for you. Either way, I'm super happy you stopped by, and I cannot wait to see you for the next reading. Au revoir. Hey, pal number two, let's get started on your reading, and are you on the right career path? We have the Queen of Cups. We have the Devil card. We have the, written upside down, Worthy card. Ten of Wands, the Knight of Swords, You Should Pursue a Different Course of Action, and Jupiter Abundance. See if this is all coming together. There we go. Wow, this is 100% interesting here, pal number, pal number two, lost my voice for a second. Well, what I see here is that I think the path that you are currently on really isn't the right one for you, pile number two. I think it's time that you should consider some changes or adjustments because, I mean, the first two cards, one is the Queen of Cups, which that's a positive card, and I think that's representative of you being somebody who is creative, beautiful, somebody who has very strong intuition, high emotional intelligence, lots of empathy, and someone who's very in tune with themselves and deeply connected to their feelings, as well as concerned with the well-being of others. But it's like you've been thrown into this world, this Devil card world, which can be very much like selfish and toxic and self-serving, and very much so every man, woman, and child for themselves. It represents having to deal with intense restrictions, sometimes environments of hostility. It could be harassment, discrimination. Like, the Devil card's pretty rough. Like, it's a very toxic work environment that we have here. And so even like manipulative, like bosses, or bosses who are like trying to control you, or bosses who can be, what's the word I'm looking for? Micromanage you, a job that drains you. Like, you're in a place that you don't need to be, that is not meant for you, that does not bring out your true qualities that involve, you're just a more peaceful person, more empathetic person. And you'll strive better in an environment that allows you to enact that empathy and to be able to connect to others in a positive way. You deserve an environment where you can feel safe around your coworkers to some degree, where there's more of a safe space, where there's more of an environment where people may acknowledge the diversity that different diversities that people have. You deserve a work culture that acknowledges that people have different sexualities, different people have different genders, people have different religions, and all of these things are respected, and we come together and have just a basic understanding of each other. And it doesn't feel like you're getting that from the career you're in now. It feels like you're getting a lot of people who can be kind of shady, who can be mean, who sometimes the Devil card can represent somebody being not paid their worth, or just not being paid at all. I've definitely gotten the Devil card to be someone who has to like fight for their money, like literally their work job won't pay them, refuses to pay them. Jobs that may refuse you, maybe you've tried to quit and they like might refuse you to quit. There have been jobs like that, like where it's just a very toxic culture is going on here. But we've talked a lot about that. But essentially, it says the cards want you to go in a different direction. A direction that's going to allow for better opportunities, more abundance, healthier relationships with your coworkers and your bosses. Having people who actually will invest in you and your career. Having a job that provides opportunities. For example, there are jobs that will pay you to take courses, or they'll give you money to go to conferences because they see that as you investing yourself and eventually investing back into the company. You deserve a company or a job that will invest in you. A job that will provide you healthcare, that will give you maternal leave, paternal leave, a job that will give you opportunities for, like, it will match your 401k, you know, things along the lines of that. When you don't have any of that, which I don't, you may have some of it for some of you, but I think a lot of you don't have a lot of that. It's kind of like this job doesn't really have strong benefits for you. You're kind of just there to get that check and leave. And even the check isn't that great from what I'm seeing here. I'm being called to pick this up. Worthy. I almost forgot about Worthy. The environment you're in isn't acknowledging your true worth. Let's look at this card, because I'm not going to read the whole thing because I don't want you to get bored. But essentially, you are enough, my dear. You are enough for your most darling hopes. You are enough for your deepest desires. You are enough for the purest of love. You are, by default, worthy of the life of your wildest dreams. I mean, that's pretty much what the direction I was going, right? Where I was saying before how you deserve so much more than this. You just deserve an environment that is going to allow you to blossom and be this naturally intuitive, creative, empathetic, emotionally intelligent person that you are. This caring individual that you are. And it's like, you're not getting any of that. You're not getting a place where you can feel emotionally safe to open up. You're not getting a place where your mental health is supported. I'm pretty sure this role you're in is not over here paying for therapy. There are jobs out there that will support and pay for your therapy. I just want to make that clear. Rather than having to pay for a medical plan that will go out of pocket, which is probably something you would have to do at your current job or position. You're not allowed to, it's like you're not allowed to dream or hope of something more when you're at this job. It's just so unfulfilling and so dead end. Like, and maybe it's just not the job, maybe it's the career. Maybe for some of you, and I'm gonna say maybe like 50, 40% of you, this has been a continuous pattern. And the only reason I say that is because the devil card deals with things that are long-term habits, which is why it deals with addictions, right? If you just smoke one cigarette and never smoke again, that's not an addiction. It represents having to do something repetitively all the time, every day. It becomes a habit, and it becomes a bad habit. And so what the cards are letting me know is you may have had to deal with this sort of energy for a long time. You may have had to deal with the constant controlling, limiting bosses, the toxic, abusive, harassment work environments, the environments that are discriminatory, the environments that are not a safe space, environments that do not look after the mental health, environments that do not support you, that do not provide you the benefits that you need and that you deserve within this lifetime. Because you deserve to have all of those things. You deserve to have a role that's secure. You deserve to have healthcare benefits. You deserve to be paid overtime for your work. You deserve to be able to have paid sick leave and paid holidays. You deserve to be able to take a 2-week vacation or 3-week vacation. You deserve all of these things. And the cards are letting me know that that is not what is happening here. And if it is happening, it's not matching what exactly it is that you're deserving of. Maybe you get, I don't know, 4 days vacation or something. Because sometimes jobs will have, like, if you are paid hourly, they'll have like an accrued, I can't even say it. They'll have an accrued, like, work time, like where you work a certain amount of hours And I can't remember. I think it's like if you work 30 hours, you get 1 hour of like vacation or something like that. It depends on the state, but I think that's like normal for the DMV area or something like that. So even if you get that vacation, it's not a lot. So they're giving you the bare minimum and you deserve so much more, pal. Number two, you're worthy. Despite whatever things that other people may be telling you, or maybe even sometimes you've told yourself. Maybe you've told yourself that you're not qualified, you don't deserve this great position, you haven't done enough to achieve this and that. But I don't think that's the truth at all. I mean, with this Ten of Wands energy, you have worked your butt off. You have put in so much work and energy. And remember, the Ten of Wands comes from that Nine of Wands. That Nine of Wands is the wounded warrior. So the Nine of Wands is fighting all these battles. Meanwhile, they've got like a broken leg. They've got the scars to show it. They're probably blind in one eye. And then the Ten of Wands is like, they're still going. Like they've probably lost their leg at this point. Maybe they have no eyesight, but if they're still there, like you've been through so much crap, pal number two. You really have. And you're still standing. And you are deserving of everything that you have worked hard for. And another thing about the Ten of Wands is highly qualified. Wands connect to your skill set, your educational level, as well as your experience. And when I have the Ten of Wands, that's somebody who can be highly experienced, highly educated. It may not be all of those things, but it's going to be at least one of those things. Somebody who is very much a passionate individual, has a lot of knowledge in their field, and is able to successfully navigate various challenges and situations. Because remember, to get to the Ten of Wands, you got to go through that Six of Wands, where you've achieved the victory. And then the Seven of Wands, where you had to prove yourself again. Right? And so it's constantly about having to push yourself and achieve victory after victory, and time after time you have proven that you can do it. But now you are at your limit. Now you are at your peak. And I was just talking about this with another card, another pal, which maybe you might feel drawn to this pal, where the Devil, and especially combined with the Ten of Wands, it represents burnout. It represents exhaustion. It represents feeling at a place where you are just completely drained. You have so many heavy burdens. You don't have time for yourself. You don't have time to take care of yourself. You are just overloaded with responsibilities, and they keep on coming. And then not only that, but with the Queen of Cups and the Devil card here, it's almost like your responsibilities and your work and the efforts that you put in are not properly being acknowledged. This Devil card energy is combined with the Queen of Cups is somebody who's very dismissive of somebody's efforts. Oh, you've only worked that hard? Oh, you get to sleep 5 hours? You're not sleeping four? Like, this is the type of energy that is very much so like, how do you call it? When people start to argue about the oppression Olympics. Like, this is like that weird energy where it's like, you mean you get a 30-minute break? You don't get no break? Like, it's just like, I had to work when I broke my arm. And it's like, okay, that's great that you suffered like that. I don't know what you're bragging on, right? So this kind of energy lets me know that people may even be undermining your struggles. They may be playing this weird oppression Olympics with you. Back in my day, we used to blah, 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 and walk 10 miles. And you're lucky to have a car. And da, da, da. Like, it's like, shut up. Like, pile number two, you got to tell these people to shut up. And if this is you in your own head, where you're saying to yourself, well, it's not that bad because of X, Y, Z. It's not that bad because, you know, I at least get to sleep at night for those 5 hours. It's not that bad because I can eat two meals a day. It's not that bad because I'm not being, harassed by my boss anymore. Like, trust me, pal number two, it is that bad. It is that bad. Whatever path that you are currently on, this is not for you. You are exhausted. Please, let's have a moment to acknowledge that. That whatever it is that you've been fighting for, whatever this energy is where you feel like you have to constantly prove yourself, because these people are keep raising the bar or keep pulling back the finish line, as they say, and creating new standards for what you need to achieve next. It's all nonsense. You're worthy of that abundance now, that Jupiter energy now. You deserve to have that coming to you right now. And I love that we got a 10 here. And also the devil card is a 10 as well. Isn't that? Am I getting that? I don't know. The devil card's 15. I'm thinking of Capricorn. But we have a 10 here. And the 10s are connected to having to end things. Having to go on to the next chapter. And I love that because it is time. Now, it's up to you to put in that effort to make those changes, but it lets me know with this 10 card energy that you're already at your peak. So regardless of whether you want that change to come in or not, I think I may have said this to another pal, that it's coming. There's nothing after the 10. It just starts a new beginning, a new chapter. And this to me is like your job, your career situation is kind of like hit this rock bottom or even dead end place, as I was mentioning before. Let us repeat this again. The path that you are currently on is not for you. You should pursue a different course of action, pal number two. This is not right. This is not right. You are not meant to have all these heavy burdens. You are not meant to be dismissed and undermined. You deserve to be validated in your feelings. You're not meant to deal with possibly even snarky remarks, things people may have said. You're not meant to deal with this weird lack of accountability when it comes to communication. I remember one time I got the Knight of Swords, and it was for like a project, and the communication was, it sounded great until we actually had to enact the actual project. And this person, it was like they acted like they had just heard all this information for the first time. And we had been talking about it for weeks. We have had emails. We've had phone calls. Like, we've discussed this to an end's length of what needs to be done. And then come day of, when they show up, they give this very Knight of Swords energy, right? This, like, I didn't study for the test. I don't know what's going on. I'm at a loss. I wasn't listening to the things you said. I'm not taking responsibility for my mistakes and my actions. It was just strange. So you may be in an environment where you have a lot of people like that, where they say one thing and they do another. Very Knight of Swords energy. Very much so where you're dealing with a lot of people who may even, I mean, for lack of better words, I just can't think of one right now, who may be kind of incompetent. And not only that, but they're putting you in situations where now you have to make the best of their mistakes and the things that they have put you through. It's like they have you second guessing yourself and your own communication and your own ability to effectively be a leader. But you have a lot of leadership abilities. For sure, pal number two. You have those leadership abilities. You're such an empathetic person. You're such an understanding person. You're willing to hear people out. But it's like people are like taking advantage of that. And they're hoping that you will make excuses for their lack of cooperation and their lack of teamwork and their lack of effort in trying to effectively do their jobs. So it's been very difficult for you to work with others because now you've had to pick up other people's slack with this Knight of Pentacles energy. And honestly, I'm like interpreting these cards and I'm getting mad for you. Like, I don't think I've ever been so mad in a reading, pile number two. Like, the stuff that you have had to put up with is utterly ridiculous, okay? So, you know what? Let's move on because we have better things coming your way. When you move to this different path, you are going to achieve so much abundance. When you decide to pursue this different course of action, what's going to come in for you are so many new opportunities, so many places, not places, but yeah, maybe new places because Jupiter can represent travel. So maybe that was a good slip of the tongue, but so many new places that you can explore, so many opportunities to expand yourself And what I love about this is I can read this as like Jupiter and Capricorn. And when Jupiter goes into Capricorn, it can do a few things depending on your chart. But I'll say the last time Jupiter went into my 10th house for me, what it did was kind of like gave me a good recommendation. And it put me in a place where people could see like my hard work, and my hard work was recognized. And I believe I might have got promoted or got a new job during that period. I don't know if I got promoted in that period. I got a new job. I got two jobs during that period. So it was like my hard work was being recognized. And I got a little bit more responsibilities at work. And I did make a little bit more money. The job at the time was temporary, but I did make a little bit more money. And then not only what came from the job was some long-term benefits where even like, I think like over like half a decade later, I can still use that job as a reference because they saw that effort that I was putting in. So what this does is it gives you a more positive representation. It makes sure that you are seen. And I think I've said this in another reading. Can't remember. You guys need to watch all my readings because I'm giving out all the information. I'm giving out all the tea with these tarot cards. I need to write a book. I am writing a book, right? I'm doing so much, I forget. The Ten of Wands represents your hard work being seen. And when we have this Jupiter and Devil card, when you start to choose and go in a different direction and a new career path, a new job, new opportunities, you're going to be seen. People are going to recognize your hard work finally. They're going to recognize your skill set finally. They're going to recognize the efforts that you put in finally. They're recognizing your passion, your ability. They're no longer giving you these meaningless, petty roles or lack of opportunities. You're finally going to get the opportunities that you deserve so that you can shine and show just how great of a person you are and just how much value you bring into the work environment. But currently, this path that you are on right now, no way, no way. You've got to go in a different direction, pal number two. You have to. There's so much more waiting on the other side. The last card we have, you should pursue a different course of action because it's going to lead to Jupiter abundance. And I remember one time when I was doing, God, this must have been so long ago, like 4 years ago. I think it might even still be on my page where I was going through nakshatras and looking at like the nakshatras that bring about the most money. And one of them, excuse me, I don't know, my nose is stuffed. And one of them is Punarvasu, which is a Jupiter ruled nakshatra, where I think they were one of the most popular placements for billionaires. And so Jupiter 100% connects to that financial abundance and being seen. And one thing about Punarvasu is what, because I, you know, I study astrology, I watch the move and everything. Oh, that just reminds me of my black male beauty study. Because Punarvasu, I didn't release the study yet, so pound number two. Punarvasu was a high placement for that, for black men who were attractive and successful. But anyway, back to what I was saying. So not only do you become more wealthy, but you may even become, people may see you in a more attractive light. They may finally recognize your beauty, recognize your vitality, your appeal. Like, you become just more appealing in multiple different areas is what I'm saying. That's why I mentioned the study. And honestly, during that time where I had Jupiter in the 10th house, I did, I believe, I lost some weight. And so, yes, I did probably fit the beauty standards more. And so, thus, I became more appealing to people. But as I was saying, what's going to come in is that you are going to be able to start achieving your goals. You're going to have a more optimistic approach when it comes to your career. You're going to have more opportunities laid in front of you. That Jupiter transit my 10th house led to more opportunities. Like I said, it led to that second job because they were looking for people, you know, who had my background, but then also they wanted somebody who was going to be hardworking, who was going to be putting in effort. You know, they're obviously looking for people who aren't lazy, right? Led to more opportunities. It will give you more leadership roles and positions of power for sure, because Devil card is always about power. And this is like expanding abundance, expanding power, expanding influence, which will give you more free will to make the decisions that you want to make. It's also going to bring about more financial endeavors, more expansions in the opportunity. And maybe quite for like a small group of you, it could be quite literal and just saying that you're going to move into the direction of like finance or something like that and management. I've seen Jupiterian people work in law, software that's popular for Jupiterian people. I'm trying to think of the Jupiterian people I know. I've seen a lot of Jupiterian bartenders, but like, which you don't expect, but yeah, like, that's something. Because like, Jupiterian people aren't technically known all, well, depending on the placement. Punavarsu is not known for indulging in indulgences. But other Jupiterian placements, yeah, they can. They're known for like the underbelly of the world, like mobsters and all these things like that. But anyway, it's like attracting abundance, being clever about how you make your money, being smart about it, being somebody who can be this network, great at networking, like the Kris Jenner effect. Like Kris Jenner, I believe she has a Punavarsu placement, Jupiterian placement. So people are seeing you as being more charming, having more responsibility, carrying yourself with integrity, and overall just being somebody that people want on their team. So once you start pursuing this different path and going in a direction that feels better and more aligns with who you are, that's when you're getting more of these abundant opportunities. That's when you're having this change in perception. That's even when people start recognizing your worth, because you are worthy pile number two. And I don't know if there's anything else I can add to this, but I think what's coming is you're about to break free from this pattern that you may have had for years of being in these weird toxic environments. You're about to pursue a career which you're at least going to be in for, I'm thinking, the next decade, or a field or job, or even like how I said I had like that recommendation that I can use like years and years later. You're at least going to move into a job that you're going to, it's going to benefit you in the long run. So even if you don't stick to that field, you're going to be able to possibly use recommendations, make contacts in that area, have some sort of, gain some sort of skill in this new direction that you're going in that you can apply further down the line. And it's going to last you a very long time. You're going to be able to use this. But essentially, what's coming for you is more growth in your career. This, when you choose this path, you're going to start to grow. You're going to start to blossom. And people are going to recognize your worth, and you're going to finally be acknowledged for every effort and bone and sweat and tear that you have put into your work for so long. So that is what I have for you, pal number two. Hopefully this resonates, and let me know if it resonates down below. I would love to hear what you have to say, you know. I love to hear what any of my astronauts say as a reader. And if this doesn't resonate, feel free to choose another pal. And it's possible I'm not the reader for you. That's okay. I'm okay with that. But either way, I'm super happy that you stopped by. And thank you for watching. Au revoir. Hey, pal number three. Let's get started on your reading and see if you're on the right career path. We have the Fool. We have the Page of Wands. We have Retreat and Restore. We have the King of Pentacles. We have the Devil. We have Fire Element Desire. And we have Follow Your Heart. Wow, that's so such a sweet message. Like, follow your heart. I love to see that. So, pile number three, I have a feeling that you have already set foot and kind of already begun the direction that you want to go in. And I say that because the first card we get here is the Fool. And the Fool is all about new beginnings, new starts, doing things that you haven't done before. So you've probably already either made the intention to set out in a new direction, or you've already pushed yourself and set out in that direction. And that's what's happening here. So when we have this question of, are you on the right career path? The answer is, yes, you are now. You're going in the right direction now. You're following your desires now. You are now following your heart, which you may not have done before. You may have been in a place where you felt like you were trapped. You couldn't fully express yourself. You were bound by somebody else's rules, somebody else's regulations, someone else's expectations. And you have broken free of that, or you're breaking free of that currently, and you're moving and going to a place that is the right fit for you. The thing that I love about this combination of cards, when we have fire element, which is Aries, Leo, Sagittarius, what fire elements mean and connect with is your own personal wants and desires, which is why you can see it says desire here. It's about what you feel like doing, about expressing yourself and who you are, about taking the initiative to do the things that you want to do, about following your gut instincts and your intuitions and your own beliefs, like a Sagittarius would do, educating yourself, expressing yourself, being creative, like a Leo, and like I said, taking the initiative, going forward, being innovative, and being true to yourself, like an Aries would be. And so now it's all about combining those energies and setting in a direction of a place where you feel like this is where you want to go. This is where you want to be. This is where you connect with. And it matches up with the Fool type of energy as well. Because the Fool card is a card of representing taking a risk, taking a chance, and kind of just throwing caution to the wind and going after the things that you desire and you want, and things that you are maybe curious about. And you're like, I wonder what would happen if I took my life in this direction. Wait a minute, I think I actually can. It's never too late to start over, which now it just brings me back to this card, this retreat and restore, where more than likely, since we have this devil card here, you've come in from such heavy energy, whether it was you being bound by your own thoughts and thinking that you couldn't achieve certain things, or you weren't provided certain opportunities for you in terms of, like, you know, your jobs, because at the end of the day, we can only work the jobs that we were offered, right? And so you may have been offered some jobs that weren't ideal for you, or maybe you started a business, but that business didn't go well. Maybe you were even limiting yourself and filtering yourself out, rejecting yourself, because there are people who, actually, this is very common, especially amongst women, where they may look at a job application and see that they only have like 70, 60% of the qualifications and they won't apply, right? That's something quite often women will do versus men more than likely will apply. I gotta find the study on that, but that's generally the sort of thought process. And so maybe you've put limitations on yourself. Maybe you have been in a place where you're like, oh no, I'm not qualified for that position. Oh no, I don't think I'd be right for that role. And you haven't fully gone after the things you want. Or possibly even you felt like the desires, the wants, and the needs that you have in this life, maybe you felt like if you moved in that direction, you wouldn't fully be supported. You couldn't financially support yourself, because we do have this King of Pentacles here. And so you are thinking about the finances. You are thinking about the practical matters. And so maybe you're like, oh, I've always wanted to be a painter, but then you have this stereotype of starving artists, and you're like, but how would I even support myself? And so you never quite went in that direction, but now you are, and now it's time. You're going in this direction, pal, number three. You're moving the direction where you feel inspired, where you feel like you can take on what it is that you want to take on and achieve that the things that you want to in this lifetime. It is about being able to recognize the things that you want and going after that, after actually taking the initiative, actually putting that force and energy behind it, actually taking a risk and taking a chance and trying a new direction or trying a new way to do things or achieve the things that you want. It's all about retreat and restore here. Let's actually look a little bit of what it's saying on this card, because when we have retreat and restore, it says, so often we underestimate the power of rest when our hearts feel heavy and our minds cannot quiet. It's often a sign that we're doing too much. The real abundance is in the power of less. You see that, pal? Number three. That makes me think that you were putting so much time and energy. You were in this devil card energy where you were doing too much, where you were putting so much force behind something, but it wasn't giving you the results that you need, that you felt fulfilled in. It wasn't making you connect with who you truly are as a person. It wasn't feeling like it was connected to your true calling and where you wanted to be in this life. And now you're taking that time, or you took that time to rest, to think about where you want to go, to understand that you deserve all of the happiness in the world. You don't have to be in a place where people don't appreciate you, they don't respect you, they don't treat you right, they don't give you the opportunities that are beneficial towards you or limiting or don't utilize all of your skill set, your expertise, your knowledge. They don't support your ambition. They don't support your ideas. Like, it's just a lack of not just support, but in a way, it's just very discouraging energy. Not only are they not supportive, but they may even actively discourage you from elevating yourself. That's where you're coming from. And you're coming from constantly trying to prove yourself to other people, trying to constantly let people know how qualified you are, how educated you are, how experienced you are, how great your ideas are. Coming from a place where you may have stuck in a situation based on fear, based on the fact that you may feel like you may not have gotten something better to come along. You may feel stuck in a situation and constantly in this workaholic cycle where you're constantly having to prove yourself because you're constantly undermined and because you're treated in a way that is not being respected, not being supported, being dismissed. Like, the devil is very much a toxic work environment. It's dealing with all of these manipulative bosses, these colleagues, having jobs that totally drain you of your energy, mentally, physically, spiritually sometimes. And you've had to pull away from that. In your mind, you're like, I can't keep this up anymore. I can't do this. What is the cost for this type of success? Even if you've had success in the past, which this King of Pentacles would indicate, it would indicate that you have had some successes, you're kind of like, was it worth all this? At what expense was this all worth it? Because now you feel exhausted. You feel like you've pushed yourself to your limit. You feel like you have drained all of the energy that you were bringing to the job. It's now lower. You're feeling burnt out and maybe even a little demoralized in a case. But now you're like, you know what? I'm done with this. I don't feel connected to this path anymore. I don't feel connected to this direction. And now you're setting off to ensure that you are getting your needs met, getting your desires fulfilled, that you're no longer in this heavy space that can be so restrictive, especially with the devil card here, that can feel like you are surrounded by people who aren't focused on the bigger picture. They're focused in on maybe what they can get, their own greeds. They're focused on their own desires for powers. But the devil card 100%, especially next to that fire sign energy, because fire signs are all about the energy, the efforts. Fire signs are all about that force you're putting behind something. It can definitely represent being burnt out. And so pile number three, I feel like you're just exhausted. You've like, I have done so much. I have sacrificed so much. I have put in so much time and effort. And it has not reaped in those benefits to the degree that you want it to. This lets me know that even though, like I said, you have had some maybe material successes, some promotions, some great opportunities, some exciting, wonderful experiences under your belt, it has not left you satisfied. It has not put you in a place where you feel that excitement, where you feel like you want to get up and do this every single day, where you feel like this is inspiring to you, because these fire sign things deal with inspiration. Now, like I said, I feel like for most of you, like almost 80%, are now course correcting and you're now on the right path. You've now decided, and that right path has to do with, like I've mentioned before, following your desires, feeling like you are passionate about what you're doing, feeling a sense of warmth when you engage with whatever it is that you are trying to achieve, your goals, your career, feeling passion for what you do. Now you're in that direction. And so now you are currently on that right path. And what the cards want you to know is that this current right path is going to bring about so many different learning experiences. Things that you've always wanted to learn, you'll get the opportunity to immerse yourself in. You'll find new things that you are passionate about, because the Page of Wands is all about finding new passions within this new direction. You're going to feel a general sense of now having optimism when it comes to your career path and your job and the directions that you're going in. You're going to feel like you are doing something that engages your passions, that makes you feel motivated, that brings a sense of excitement to you every day. And there are a lot of new things coming in, because the Page of Wands, like I mentioned before, it always represents those new passions, those new interests, these new opportunities to do things that you weren't presented with before. New projects, new creative endeavors, and it's going to all be very exciting. It's going to come in very fast as well, because the Page of Wands is a fast moving element. Like, it's one of those fast messengers. Like, I'm going to give you this message real quick. Page of Wands is probably representative of text messages. I feel like Page of Wands is text messages, and I feel like maybe the Page of Pentacles or the Knight of Pentacles is like sending somebody like a letter or something. But but Page of Wands is sending you that quick text message. And so it's letting me know that these opportunities are coming in quick. And obviously with the Fool here, clarified by the Page of Wands, these are new opportunities. These are opportunities in which that you can feel like you can finally explore fully your calling. That you can feel like you are now being offered offered opportunities to express yourself, to bring your ideas to life, because you are bursting with ideas. You are bursting with inspiration, and you want to put these things out there. In the past, you have been so limited and you've been so drained. You haven't properly been able to express yourself. Now you're getting that revitalization of energy. Now you're able to be inspired to do the things that you want to do again. Now you're able to take the risk that you want to take. Now you're going to go into uncharted territories where you're going to obviously meet new challenges. We have the devil here. The devil here is definitely going to bring you new challenges, but it doesn't matter because you're going to feel so inspired to tackle these things, to keep going in that direction. And it's just going to bring about this new revitalized sense of self. If that makes sense for you, pal, number three, if you have felt so burnt out, if you have felt so demoralized, if you felt like your efforts haven't been giving you everything that you have wanted and desired, now you're moving in that direction. You're moving in that direction and you are being supported by the universe. This is you stepping out, taking faith, and going in the place that you know will fulfill your desires. And I don't think it's all the time for you, pal number three, because some of you, it might literally be like a break. I feel like 30% of you, this is like literally you're taking time off to take a break, to revamp, and then go in that different direction. But then for the rest of you, it's less about taking that physical break and more so about just having your energy feel revitalized, having you being able to be recharged, because now you're bringing in all of these fresh ideas. Now you're taking those leaps of faith and you feel like you want to. You feel like you want to put yourself out there. You feel like you want to put your neck on the line. You feel like it's worth it now, because now you have more control and you have more control of the direction that you want to go in into this life. You have more control over it, is that what you want to do in your career path. You have a lot of support when it comes to the universe and how it wants you to move forward. And not only that, but what the cards are saying here is it's going to bring about a lot of success for you. It's going to put you in the place where you are someone who is highly like knowledgeable when it comes to your field, because the King of Coins has to do with having a lot of practical knowledge, as well as it is someone who is very much having a good reputation and being this down-to-earth person. So it's bringing about a lot of positivity when it comes to your reputation. It's bringing about a sense of having a lot of financial backing. So if you were starting a business, this would be you being able to be supported through investors. It's being somebody who, when it comes to managing your finances and feeling like you're being paid your worth, you're being paid your worth. Number one, with the King of Coins, is like, okay, I'm paid my worth. I have a sense of security and stability coming my way through this new path. And like I said, this is you following your passions and gaining that support and stability through your passions. It can be about business ownership. That's something to keep in mind, especially the devil. I mean, we talk a lot of trash about the devil card, but the devil card at the end of the day is a boss, and it can represent having a financial mastery over something, because the devil card relates to material wealth. And so this new career is bringing about new financial opportunities, and you'll be dealing with larger sums of money than you have dealt with in the past. If it's you being a business owner, then this is you managing your finances for your business. and taking a more practical and knowledgeable mindset when it comes to how you want to keep those records, how you want to pay those taxes, and the information that comes with tax deductions that you can take for your business and et cetera, financial investments, return on investments, all these things, you become a little bit more masterful in the financial realm when it comes to that. And if this is you working for someone else, this is you being respected at that job, being in a position of leadership, somebody who's going to oversee others, and maybe even possibly with the King of Pentacles, your job may deal a little bit with budgets and finances or purchasing, procurements, things along the lines of that. And this new deal, this new job that you're getting, this, if you're already on this, if you're completely switching career paths, this new career path is going to bring about a lot of security and a lot of stability and a lot of material gains. The Devil card is that ultimate material gains card, okay? I don't know how you can get more material gains. Maybe with if I pulled something like a Taurus astrology card or something, that would think that's going to be more material gains or something like that. But the Devil card always makes sure they get paid on time, okay? They're all about taking control of that financial knowledge and financial areas in their life. So now you're dealing with larger sums of income. You're gaining more material success, abundance, and wealth. And it's all because you've chosen to follow your heart, pile number three. And I think that covers everything that I want to say about that. Because really, long-term, career-wise, this is bringing about all of that stability that you were maybe worried about in the past when it comes to following your dreams and following your heart. And Spirit is letting you know that you don't have to worry about that. There will be some challenges, but it's going to come through and you are going to achieve that financial long-term stability and possibly even generational wealth, because the King of Pentacles relates to that element. So please let me know if this resonates down below, pile number three. If not, feel free to choose a new pile or choose a different reader. I can't even speak. Either way, I'm happy you stopped by. Wait, as I was closing out, it made me think of the overarching message, which I don't think I said. Make sure that you stay grounded and committed to your passions, pile number three. Follow your instincts. It will guide you towards success. Don't believe in these underlying fears that you won't achieve success when times get rough, or listening to anybody else who may be discouraging you. Success is guaranteed long as you are able to balance a sense of spontaneity with a level of intelligence and practicality when it comes to how you are approaching your career. You are guaranteed to achieve success. Now that is what I have to say, and I will see you next time. Au revoir. Hey, pile number four. Let's get started on your reading. Are you on the right career path? We have the Five of Wands, the Ten of Cups, a little bit more reversed in that way. We have, I can't even read that. Oh, Reborn. I can't stand the cursive writings. We have the Five of Pentacles. We have the Five of Swords. Wow, it's so many fives. Number four, what's going on? We have Leo, I will. Funny thing about Leo is it's connected to the fifth house. We have a lot of five energy. And Let It Go. Ooh, pile number four. What's happening here? Well, we already know what's happening. Are you on the right career path? You're about to be, if you're not. honestly, pile number five. This is the way I'm going to read this. 50% of you have already gone through a lot of changes. Because when I have all these fives here, normally I get fives to represent, well, fives to represent in numerology represents change, represents actions, represents challenges, represents excitement, represents transformation in a way, represents freedom and independence. It also represents kind of like exploration and adaptability. I had like a 5 year, and that my 5 year was all last year. And let me tell you, from losing a job to getting a relationship to starting school to getting another job, like it's just like it, from traveling the world, like it was just so random. So pound number four. Expect the unexpected, okay? You don't have a choice to be on the right career path for now. It's coming, okay? So for 50% of you, I'm going to say yes. You are on the right career path for the most part, probably even more than 50%. And then for the other 50% of you, I'm going to let you know you're about to be on the right career path. And the thing is about it is, how do I explain this? I'm trying to use my words correctly. We have the phrase "let it go." Let it go deals with not wanting to change, not wanting to develop. Basically, the opposite of five energy here. So the other 50% of you is a little bit stuck or a little bit resistant to wanting to change and develop and grow, which makes sense because we're all like that. It's scary to change. It's anxiety inducing to have to throw yourself to the wind and not know what's coming next and just kind of go with the flow. That's terrifying. Like you to just know that the possibilities are endless, good and bad. That means anything could happen. And to embrace that change means anything can happen to you. So pound number four, this five energy is letting me know that some of you are about to be thrusted in the change. And I think the universe is already letting you know that the career path you are currently on isn't the right one for you. This is the 50% that haven't gone into any major changes. I'm going to get to the other 50% first. Where you've been stuck kind of doing the same job or career for a long time. You haven't really been challenged. You know what to expect from your day-to-day routine. You know what time you need to clock in. You know what time you need to show up from work. You know the tasks that you need to do. Things along the lines of that. You are used to a routine. That 50% of you, you're about to have your world rocked. And you're about to be thrusted on the right path. So if you find that you have already not developed and made changes, it's coming for you. It sounds like a horror movie. It's coming. Like, you know, but it is coming for you, pile number four. That's for those of you who haven't made those developments and changes. But I think for the other 50% of you, you've already had your world rocked. You've already been turned inside out and upside down. And what the cards are kind of saying here is there may be even some part of you who still kind of thinks about your old path and thinks about your old career and thinks about your own job and says, man, I kind of wish, you know, I kind of wish that that had worked out, or I kind of wish that, you know, things could have stayed in that direction, or I kind of wish, you know, that you had gained what you had envisioned yourself gaining at that old role or that old position or that old job or that old career. There's a part of you that still wishes that. And that's why we got this let it go. Because the universe here understands that. It understands that it's hard to develop. It's hard to grow. It's challenging to accept a new role when you have been in a certain position for so long. It can be very, very scary to be reborn, which is what's happening to you, pile number four. So for those of you who have already had your world rocked or who are currently going through it, because there's a mixture of energy here. What's happening is that you're being reborn. You're letting go of the old you, the old path that you were on, and you're taking on a new role and transitioning into a place that is more exciting and more fulfilling. Because we have this Ten of Cups here, And this Ten of Cups here lets me know that where you currently are at or where you currently were wasn't the best fit for you and didn't fulfill you in all the ways that you deserve to be fulfilled. It didn't supply the happiness that is meant for you in this new role, this new environment, this new career, and this new change. What's coming for you is a place in which you can feel totally welcomed, totally happy, and completely and utterly emotionally satisfied and content. And that's the place Spirit wants you to be at. It's not saying that you didn't get something before from the previous roles or jobs that you had, but it's saying that there's more out there for you. And I think you know it yourself that something was missing. It wasn't quite it. And the thing that I love about this let it go energy is a 10 of cups, all 10s represent completion, right? And this is kind of like you reversed in this position, holding on to that old dream. Holding on to that old life, that old you, that's no longer suited for the future success and fulfillment that you are going to have. It's time to take on a new chapter. It's time to develop and grow into a new era. And it's time to welcome yourself into this new role. I kind of want to look at what the reborn says. Out of the ashes, you shall rise. The tears you once shed will pave the way for all that is light and free. And from this depth, you will arrive as your ultimate truth, your ultimate joy. And that's all about being rebuilt. So it kind of just said exactly what I said before, where you are now on the path to the place of your ultimate joy. So if you've noticed all of these strange changes, like maybe you lost a job, maybe somebody, I don't know, broke up with you and that caused you to be depressed or something along the lines of that. Maybe that you've had people reach out to you about certain things. Maybe you've had a lot of chaos and backstabbing and weirdness happening at work. And it's just made it a very uncomfortable and difficult environment. Maybe you've been struggling to find a job because you've been applying for very similar roles and it's been based on your past expertise, but the universe wants you to completely make a leap and go in a totally different direction. And that's why you're having a lot of issues in that department. Maybe you constantly have found yourself struggling for money, struggling to get someone to value you and see you for your worth. Struggling to be paid a fair amount for the work and the effort that you put in. And also, I should probably reverse this as well because this is a sword next to a pentacle. And so this Five of Swords energy, when it's reversed like this, this can have to do with, well, it can be two things. One, it can do with self-sabotage. Almost like you are fighting yourself, similar to that let go energy. Letting go of situations that are so difficult. Choosing the path of least resistance. Picking and choosing your battles wisely. If you have been going through career struggle after career struggle, if you've had jerk bosses, if you've had people not pay you correctly, if you've had a lot of chaos and instability and poor management, it's because that path was not meant for you. At least it's not anymore. If you're currently going through that, that's the universe letting you know, get out of there. We don't want you there anymore. We want you doing something different. What do you want them doing? That's what you want to know? They want you to do something you're passionate about. We got Leo energy here. And we all know Leo is that sign, that fiery, standout, kind of show off, entertainment, I'm funny, I'm beautiful, I'm smart, like kind of sign, right? It's very much like in your face. That's what Leo's known for, being sociable, being excitable, being somebody who can put on a show for everyone. Which when it connects to these cards, it lets me know that Spirit wants you to follow something that's going to make you passionate, possibly even quite literally being in some sort of media field or a place where you can gain attention. It could be radio, it could be television, it could be having your own social media business, something along the lines of that. It could be like an influencer. It doesn't have to be those things, but whatever the case may be, I mean, I'm just thinking of like traditional media, but technically, this could represent being in a role where all eyes are on you. So being a teacher, being a professor, being someone who is an instructor, being a guide, basically a role in which you have to present yourself and perform in a way. Perform and have eyes on you, and you be the center talking to some sort of audience, a speaker, a presenter, whatever the case may be, but the universe wants all eyes on you. It wants more focus on you. It wants you to be the center of attention a little bit more. And I was going to go into another aspect when it comes to Leo. This can also represent where the cards want you to focus on your education, because Leo connects to the fifth house. So many fives, right? Fifth house of education, fifth house of development and skills. So this is about learning new skills. This is about possibly, if you haven't achieved your degree, getting your degree or going back to school. This is definitely having to do with expressing yourself creatively. Spirit wants you in a career where you're doing something like that. Like, how can you express yourself creatively? How can you, I don't know, teach someone? Spirit wants you in a place where you are developing new skills, where you are socializing, whether you are entertaining people, something that is going to bring you fulfillment and passion. Leo is all about that passion and joy. In astrology, the fifth house Leo connects to the placement of kind of like fun. Like, it's the house of like free time. It's the house of enjoyment and fulfillment. It's like, what do you do for fun? So what spirit and what the universe is asking you to do is let go of this current, ooh, it just came to me. Let go of old mindsets where you feel like, if you feel like you have to take on some sort of corporate role, where you have to take a more practical approach, where you have to take a more streamlined, acceptable by society route to success, you don't have to do that. The cards are letting you know that you can just follow your passions and you will achieve so much happiness, so much fulfillment. You won't have to deal with the not having enough money, the wild coworkers and bosses, the feeling that you are not in the right role, the feeling that something is missing, the feeling that you can't achieve your desires, dealing, like I said, with the strange environments and the chaos and the nitpicking and the backstabbing and just the strange office politics. When you follow your passions, when you follow your dreams, I'm not saying it won't be difficult. We got dang near every five in the deck. but I'm saying it will be worthwhile and you will be fulfilled and you will finally get that happiness that you desire. Like, this is the happiest card in like the deck. I don't know how this represents total elation and happiness. Even reversed, it's still a happy card, but it's just like, oh, something's a little bit missing, which is where you were or where you currently are at now. But it's letting me know that you're about to achieve so much fulfillment and satisfaction and getting all of your dreams come true, especially within the realm of career, especially if you follow your passions and your dreams and your desires and what you do for fun. What are you doing for fun, pal? Number four. Do that as a career. I don't know how much, be more straightforward. Oh, you know what? Don't tell the other pals about this, pal number four. I'm going to pull another card for you because I want to see what's going on here. Like, I want to go a little bit deeper. Ooh, okay. This is exactly what I was saying. How when you This is Pluto, by the way. When you finally step into your zone, and hold on, sorry, my thoughts jump all over the place. Pluto also connects to rebirth and reborn out from the ashes of the phoenix. It also connects to judgment, which is also about being reborn, and judgment day and waking from the dead. I just had to make that connection again because it's coming up twice and being reborn. But when you finally go after your passions, when you finally go after the things that you desire, when you finally make those hobbies into a career, which sounds insane, I know, because, I mean, look at all these fives, it's going to be hard. But when you finally make this thing into a career, you're going to step into your power. You're going to achieve things beyond your wildest imaginations. You are going to achieve such emotional fulfillment. I remember recently I took a trip to Japan and it falls on my Pluto line, guys. And I've heard so many disaster stories about things falling on your Pluto line, about things being being stressful and kind of like, you know, scary or things like that. When I tell you, when I entered my Pluto line in Japan, that is the happiest I've ever been in my entire life. Pluto not only connects to these scary up and down, terrifying situations, but it also connects to just having high intense emotions. And one and a high intense emotion is total and complete happiness, like this 10 of cups. Pluto can represent being intensely satisfied when you follow your career and your passions. I'm not saying just to throw everything to the side, throw everything to the wind and not have some sort of stability, but I'm saying you need to develop this area. The cards are like begging you to. They want you to, they desire you to, and they think you will be so much happier this way. They think that you are going to be somebody who is finally stepping into their element, finally stepping into their power, finally achieving the wealth that you want, finally achieving the environment that you want, the people that you want to be around it, finally feeling like you are in the right place for yourself, finally having this magnetic influence, and you're going to have such a powerful influence in the area that you're choosing to be creative in, or if you're teaching. That's also something. I'm focusing on the creativity because I guess in a way I'm more of a creative. But if you are somebody who also wants to be like a teacher or teach somebody a skill, or you're just gaining a new skill, this represents being in such a powerful magnetic position that it makes you a little bit more highly desirable and highly sought after, especially if you are developing some skill in some area. You're going to be one of those people who a lot of... The camera's heating up, guys, so let me get to this out the way. Pluto can represent somebody in a field who is highly sought after, highly skilled, and very powerful within the area that they are specialized in. And so if you have a special skill set, if you're developing one now, if you are gaining a new one, because the cards want you to gain that new one, this is about being reborn, you are going to be one of those super experts and have a lot of power and influence in that area. And so it's going to bring in a lot of wealth. It's going to bring in a lot of clientele. It's going to completely transform your life. I do want to say that. And as I mentioned before, Pluto is not superficial happiness. It represents this deep, beyond surface level excitement and joy. It is an intense emotional fulfillment. So you're going to be like walking on cloud nine, like past cloud nine, really, because if you think of it, nine of cups is cloud nine, 10 of cups is past it. And so you're going to get to that place, but only if you let go, pile number four. So are you on the right career path? It looks like you're about to be if you already haven't been, if that makes sense. Like I said, it's like the 50% who is resisting change. Yeah, you're about to be on the right career path. For those of you who are already in the mix, who've already gone through the chaos or are going through it right now, yeah, you're on the right career path. If things feel a little crazy and wild right now, if things feel stressful as hell, sorry, I gotta curse a little bit. If things feel that stressful, you're right there. You're right where the universe wants you to be. If you're like, I'm not making enough money, this is stressful and I gotta do this thing. Like, yep. You are on the right path, pal number for. And I will see you next time. Hopefully this resonates. Please let me know if it resonates down below. I would love to hear from you. I love hearing from you. And that is all I have to say for now. Like, comment, and subscribe. Au revoir. Hey, pal. Number 5. Let's get started on your reading. Are you on the right career path? We have the 8 of Wands, the 2 of Wands. We have Joy, 8 of Swords, the Emperor, Void of Course, and you already know. Wow, pal, number 5. The cards are wondering why you're even asking, because you already have the answer. The first thing that pops off of me is the Void of Course Moon, which we already know the Void of Course Moon is a transitional period. It's when the moon leaves a sign and it's not making any more aspects until it gets to another sign. And something to note about this is it's possibly saying, it says a few things. One, a lot of you are already in this transitional period. So if you're like, am I on the right career path? It's like, well, you're already moving in the direction that you know you want to go and that you know you need to be. And maybe you're just looking for that reassurance and that validation here, because the Void of Course Moon is already on its path. It's already on its course. It's already going the direction that it wants to go in and that it needs to go in. Okay? You're already moving in that way. And so automatically, this to me is like, yes, like you know that you are moving away from this situation where you've already had a lot of experiences, you've already reached your capacity of growth, because that's what the Void of Course Moon is. It's saying, hey, there's nothing more I can do here. So you've probably already reached a point in your career or, you know, job situations where you feel like, I've kind of reached a dead end with this situation. There is no more upward mobility that I can go, or direction that I can go in to develop or grow, either within a certain job or within a certain career. Perhaps you're already looking for a career transition. These cards would indicate you are at least looking for a new role or a new opportunity or a new job, but whatever the case is, you know right now where you're currently at, you have reached your limitations and it's time for you to move on. This is a closure chapter. This is you saying goodbye to the area of life that you are in currently in your career and moving on to something better. You're moving on to a place where you feel grounded, a place where you feel secure. That's why we have this Emperor card here. It's showing you on your throne. It's showing you at a place where you are just in this position where you know what to do. You have the confidence in your abilities. And not only that, but you have the respect earned from your colleagues and your peers, as well as those who may be above you in a position of authority. The Void of Course Moon is all about letting go and setting new intentions for this new path that you are on. And I love this for you, pal, number 5. You are being so supported by the universe, spirit. They are all letting you know that you are moving in the right direction. And honestly, you're moving really fast. Okay, so it may feel like right now things are... there's a lot of ideas and opportunities or developments that are happening, or even just circumstances and situations that are happening. Perhaps you're getting a lot of callbacks for jobs, or perhaps you're even throwing out a lot of resumes, because the 8 of Wands can represent both, where you're like, okay, I've thrown so many things out there. Now I'm a little bit waiting. To see what's going to happen. I've already set those intentions, which I think is probably going to be maybe 60-70% of you thinking along this lines, where you've already thrown those intentions out there. You've already put in the job applications. You've already decided to go back to school. You've already decided to switch roles or careers. You've already decided to start your own business. Whatever the case may be, it's like you've already decided and started these things, but you're waiting on a few elements. You know, that's what that Void of Course Moon is. It's a time period where it's not necessarily extremely active, but it is about readying yourself emotionally for these developments to take place. It's about thinking a little bit along the lines of, what are my long-term goals? What am I trying to accomplish? And the Two of Wands, what I love about this is these two cards fit so well together, because the Two of Wands is always about preparedness. It's always about thinking things over. It's all about moving towards that next transition. But it's in this phase where it's not really able to make a huge amount of momentum and movement forward, because it's still preparing and welcoming energy for that next shift and that next development. But a transition is definitely occurring, because the one thing about the Two of Wands, which I don't know if you can see on this card, but the Two of Wands has one foot out the door. So it's already like, I'm already one foot out the door. If you already have a job and you're like, this is you being one foot out the door, I'm ready to leave. This is you saying, I've already, you know, like I said, put out those resumes. I've already tried networking. I've already updated my LinkedIn. I've already started talking and going to seminars for professionals. Like, you've already gauged and looked at new opportunities and already envisioned the life that you want. And things are starting to develop, or they will start to develop very, very soon. If they don't already, as I said already, I think things are starting, they're going to pick up and move at a little bit of a faster pace. Or this is potentially you picking up and moving things faster, because you already know. You already know, pile number five. You already know where you currently at, or where you currently were at, because some of you are maybe a little bit further along in the process when it comes to taking on that new transition into that new job prospect, that new career prospect. Some of you might be a little bit further along, but you already know that you are bigger than the situations that you have been placed in the past. It does not connect with you anymore. It is not something that is developing you any more than it can be. It doesn't bring you that joy. It doesn't bring you that fulfillment. There's nothing left when it comes to staying in your current role, in your current position. And that's why you're strategizing. That's why you're moving forward. That's why that's why you already have a feeling that this isn't right for you. You already know. You already know this is just not the fit for you anymore. So you're moving towards the career path that you deserve and that you belong to, and sorry, that you belong in. And maybe some of you too, I don't know. That might've been like a, for somebody, but it's just going to feel right. You're going to find that place where things just feel right. And one thing about this is these three cards in particular connect a lot to strategy. So I think a lot of you are trying to strategize how you can get to the place that you want to be. You're taking a serious look at how you can develop and grow in the direction and momentum that you want to grow in. I've gotten the Two of Wands. Excuse me. I've gotten the Two of Wands to represent sort of planning and thinking about how I personally might want to move with my tarot channel or astrology channel. It just kind of represents thinking about the bigger picture and thinking about the bigger vision for things. And I think you're already doing that. You already have things set in motion. You already feel like there's been a lot of recent changes and developments, and that you cannot currently stay where you are. But let's get into this Eight of Swords here. When we have this Eight of Swords energy, it kind of goes back to what I was saying earlier with pile number five. Are you just kind of looking for somebody to say, yes, you're going the right way, you're doing the right thing, this is you, all your ideas are great, you are somebody who deserves the things that you desire in this world? Are you looking for that validation? Because this Eight of Swords energy is a little bit more shy, reserved. They don't always quite believe in themselves. But the cards are here letting you know that you have everything it takes to succeed and get to where you need to go. We have the Emperor here. The Emperor sits on their throne. You're already moving in the right direction. And to even clarify this, because we have the Emperor being a card of leadership, I mean, who's got the higher position or better job than the Emperor? You know what I mean? Like, come on. Like, pile number five, you don't even need me here. Like, because whether you clicked on this reading or not, I mean, maybe you just need that pump or that initial push to go forward. But, like, everything here is validating you and letting you know that you're somebody who can achieve anything you set your mind to. And not only can you achieve it, but you're going to be good at it. You're going to be good at this new role you're thinking about, this new role you're trying to transition to, this new job you're trying to transition to. It's going to be a way more fulfilling environment or place for you, or even this new business you might be trying to take on. Maybe you have a lot of ideas and you want to start a business, or you want to be a social media influencer or something along the lines of that. Whatever the case may be, whatever it is that's drawing you and pulling you in, it's letting you know that you're going to be somebody who is going to actually be fantastic at it. People are going to have a lot of respect. They're going to look up to you. They're going to seek guidance from you, going to seek advice from you on whatever it is that this new role and position that you are positioning yourself for. Because you don't really need that help. Don't get me wrong. Help is always great. And it's always fantastic, especially with the Emperor here, but you have such a strong willpower and force behind you and passion and drive that you don't really necessarily need a lot of support and things going on to secure the role that is meant for you, which some placements or some piles may need. And I got a little bit distracted talking about, like, how you were just meant to be at this new direction that you're going in, that I forgot to mention that we have two eights here. And you know what eights represent? Is they represent power and authority and leadership, which is why I was saying before, with the Emperor, this new role that you're transitioning to, this new path that you're taking, this new area of life that you're going in when it comes to your career, this new chapter, you are going to be somebody who is going to be seen as a respectable figure, a person who has very strong leadership qualities, very strong, maybe managerial qualities, whatever the case may be, but people are looking towards you to, as a person who can lead and guide and instruct others, which means that you're going to have a lot of knowledge, or you're going to gain a lot of knowledge and information and skill set in this area that you are looking to take on and tackle and go into, or this new job or role, whatever the case may be with your career. We already know you're transitioning and you're moving in that direction. But whatever the case is saying, it's saying you're taking on more responsibilities. And not only that, but people are now looking up to you and asking you answers, asking you questions, and you're the one who's going to be providing that the answers. You're the one who's going to be providing directions. And on top of that, you know what eights signify? Eights connect to material wealth and success, pile number five. So we already know that's waiting for you on the other side. We already know that's waiting for you, and we didn't even get into joy, because that material wealth and success is coming, especially when we have these two eight cards here. They're closely linked to business success. So if you guys are starting a business, this is almost like a double whammy for you, especially if you're the more independent you are with the eights, and the more that you are putting your own vision and thought process behind something, which starting a business is like kind of all of your energy, the more success that you likely will have. But even if you're not interested in that, you're still going to gain success, pile number five. It's coming. I don't know how else to say this. As I was saying with joy here, joy obviously represents being able to enjoy yourself. I want to read the full card here, but And I'm just going to read a brief piece because we don't want this to be too long. Go ahead, feel it. Pure, radiating, unapologetic joy. Feel your smile spread from ear to ear as your heart swells with utter bliss. Joy is all around us in everything. And that is what's waiting for you, pal number five. You're going to have a lot more joy at this next role, this next position, this next job. You're going to be on the move a lot. You're going to gain so much confidence, so much reassurance. It's going to feel like you're going to feel like vindicated from like all this, you know, stuff that you've had to deal with. I almost cursed a bit from all that stuff that you had to deal with from all. And you already know what stuff I'm talking about. I don't even have to say it with these cards. You know, we already got this Eight of Swords and the Emperor has to deal with so many people, you know, coming for their neck. Right. Heavy as the head that wears a crown. Right. So we already know you've dealt with a lot of BS in the past. But this next transition, this next role, this next opportunity that is coming and that you are, I say coming, but honestly, you're the one who's pushing it. You're the one who's moving towards it. But let's say you guys are moving towards each other. I'll say you, this role that is coming and this role that you are pushing towards is going to be something that is so joyous and bring you so much fulfillment where you're going to feel like, I just love coming to work. I love being able to express my ideas. I love the things that I do in this lifetime. I love being able to bring my own uniqueness and character into the roles. And one thing, I think I mentioned this before in another reading, is about the Void of Course Moon, is that it can't be pinned down. And when we talk about something that can't be pinned down, it means that it's very original, it's very unique. As well as the Two of Wands. That also represents being unique, being an individual, being someone who marches to the beat of their own drum. So this next role that you are in, this next transition, this next chapter in your career path is going to be something that's maybe a little bit different or a little bit unusual in terms of the thing that you might be taking on. It may not be a typical role that people take, or it may be a job specifically might be created for you. It's either going to be that, or for the other half of you, it's going to be that you can fully kind of express and be yourself in your role, in your new job. And it's not going to be a problem. People are going to be very welcoming towards it. They're going to feel like, they're just going to feel like a good vibe from you. It's kind of like that joy energy that I was mentioning before. They're going to feel like, oh, wow, this person is very unique, very much like a cool individual. I feel like we're getting a lot of innovative ideas from them. They're smart. They know their stuff. Like, people are feeling like in this next role that you are somebody who brings a sense of enlightenment to the room in terms of your intellect, and then you're also bringing a lightness into the room in terms of your attitude. So very much so more welcomingness at this new role, new position. Not only do you feel welcomed, but the people around you feel comforted by your presence is something that I have to mention, pal number five. So are you on the right career path? If you weren't, which, like I said, it's going to depend on where you are at this stage. Most of you are now moving towards the right career path. And some of you already have that ideal in your head. You're like, I think this isn't for me anymore. And those of you who already have that idea in their head, come on, you already know. You already know that this role that you're currently in is not for you, and you're going to move to a different position, a new career, a new job, probably more sooner than later. There's going to be some changes that are taking place. There's a lot of action coming in. I want to say that because the first card we pulled was that Eight of Wands. So there's a lot of action and momentum. And the Eight of Wands, you know what it also represents? It represents clear direction. So once again, you already know. Pile number five, you already have a clear direction. You already have a clear insight. You already have that inkling of a feeling inside of you saying that where you're currently at isn't right and you need to get to your karmic position. this position that was meant to you, this position that was destined for you. And I only mentioned, I never mentioned destiny and all that, but if we have 2 8s, which connect to karma and destiny, I kind of have to. So it would be weird of me not to in that case, especially when we have void of course moon, which is like, there's nothing that you could do about this situation. This is just how it is. So you're already on the path moving to where your destiny is supposed to be, where you're supposed to lie, and it's picking up momentum. So if you feel like you're not sure about what decision you want to make, that decision is going to be made for you really soon, is what I want to say, pile number 5. But yeah, I wish you the best of luck. Like, there's so much good things happening for you. I cannot believe you got the Emperor. Like, there's no better card we can get when it comes to a career, pile number 5. I mean, what more can we say? This new place that you're going to be at, if you're thinking about starting a business, that business is going to go so well. If you're thinking about switching some sort of career, making a career transition, you're going to do fantastic. And you're going to bring so much innovation and idealism and excitement into that role that people are going to be sort of like enamored with your opinion and what you have to say. So that is what I have. And I will hopefully, let me know if it resonates, number one. And hopefully I will see you next time. If it doesn't resonate, feel free to choose another pal or possibly I'm not the reader for you. Either way, I'm happy you stopped by and thank you so much, pal number 5. Au revoir.